Hey guys, and welcome to another video here for our channel, The Guide. I'm Benjamin, also known as Taz, and in this video, we will talk about how you can deal with pace, how you can counter pace as a defender. We all know the pain, your opponent rushes through your defensive line, you are trailing with your defenders, and in the end, you concede the goal. Pace seems very overpowered in FIFA 21, but now you get 6 tips how to manage it better. Techniques and concepts that help you to get control over the situation before it unfolds and pace won't be as important anymore. So let's get right into it with the first tip. An early player selection is basically the first boundary in your defense. By reading the next play of your opponent and the proper reaction to it by selecting the player early, you can ruin the attempt of your opponent before it has even started. Switching early to the defender allows you to pick up the running path of the attacker. You get your defender in a proper position to either intercept the pass right away or at least make sure that your player is already moving in the right direction. This helps you to overcome a potential disadvantage in a running duel, when your defender still has to accelerate whereas the attacker is already sprinting in full sprint. Right stick player switching is a key element of this. We already have several videos on this topic and you can find the links in the video description. So how do you know when to switch early to a player in your defensive line? This is most often the case when your opponent has some space around the midfield and can open himself up for a deep pass up front. Through passes are extremely strong in FIFA 21 and thus they are the most popular choice in situations like this. So in that moment, try to understand to which player he's likely to play a deep through pass to and select the defender which has the best position to challenge this attempt of chance creation, either blocking the passing lane or running path of the attacker. Here my opponent has quite some space on his way going forward and an attacker right in front of him. I anticipate that he will initiate a run of his attacker and try to play a through pass. Look how poor the positioning of my defender is right in the moment when I switch to him. But because I was early enough, I was able to accelerate, move him back, and in the end win that running duel despite having the slower player. The next tip is about how to behave in a running duel itself. Because with a poor choice of running pathway, you can get yourself in a really unfavorable position at which you're bound to lose control over the situation. Before we talk about the running path itself, we take one step back and make us aware what one of the key principles is in defending. You want to have a position at which we can be an obstacle for the opponent on his way on goal. Meaning as long as you are in front of the opponent, you can challenge him or influence his next options to get closer to the goal. With this key principle as the foundation, we can derive a clear way how we should behave in running duels. Try to take a shorter path towards your own goal. This means running straight back to your own goal, focused more on the inside to have a shorter way. There is no need to follow the attacker and go as wide. In the end, the opponent will try to get to the inside as well. As you don't have to dribble and manage the ball, you as a defender have more freedom how you can run and thus it's easy to get in a better position than the attacker. One important aspect here in managing the running duel is that you don't get caught up behind the opponent on one side, for example the outside, and get stuck. When you try to challenge the opponent too early, when you're not in a good position, your opponent can get rid of you with good use of the shielding function, slowing you down in your attempt of going back. Therefore, focus first on gaining ground on the opponent by avoiding him and taking the shorter path to then have a better position on him for a duel. In this situation, I was a little bit unfortunate about the clearance, getting me in a very disadvantaged position. As soon as I realized that I don't have a chance to recover that open ball, I focus on running straight back with Van Dijk, instead of chasing the opponent's Torres on the outside. See how much ground I gained because of that decision and how in the end I'm in a very good position to defend him in a 1v1 straight up. Before we come to the next tip, I want to make you aware of one of the best and most efficient ways to improve your skill in FIFA, getting your own professional coach for your individual training. We offer this service for over 7 years and our pro, top 200 and elite coaches have plenty of experience to help you to reach your personal goals. Just recently we started coaching in Spanish as well. In the video description you can find the link to our coaching website. We also offer nice bundles which combine coaching and access to our premium platform, The Guide Plus. Make sure to check it out. The next tip might be the most important tip for all of them. because it's not as intuitive and deals in particular with a characteristic of FIFA 21. I'm referring to the behavior of AI defenders. In some situations, they are completely headless in the way they position themselves, and this can totally screw you over when you rely on them too much. This is due to the efforts of EA to make AI defending not as strong. So how can we counter this? Once again, we try to anticipate what is about to happen and be one step ahead. In this case, we are talking about situations at which you are likely to take a very unfavorable duel with your defender that you have selected at that moment. Yes, you could try to challenge the opponent, but there is a decent chance that you fail. In the meantime, you can't count on your AI teammate to be in a position to help you afterwards. So that's why you have to be one step ahead and don't take the unfavorable duel in the first place, but switch to the defender who is in a better position after all. That way you make sure that you have control over the situation the whole time. So in a nutshell, when you have the option to try to challenge your opponent from a bad position, like from behind or the side, or you can switch to a defender who can a little bit later get in a position to challenge the opponent, I recommend to do the latter. Switch to this player and stay in control over the situation instead of failing with the first player and then not having another player who you can fall back to. This is a perfect example how the AI defenders would screw you up. While I'm tangled up in the duel with Rashford, you can see how my center back is about to move away. I know that when I lose this duel, I would have a problem when Rashford then can fully accelerate and run through on goal, because the center back might be in a poor position and also not moving backwards. That's why I don't commit anymore in this risky duel, but instead switch to my center back so I'm able to keep this situation under control. Don't rely on your AI defenders too much, as this can catch you totally off guard. So now, after you incorporated all of these tips, meaning early player switching, shorter running pass and maybe another player switch, you should be in a much better position for a potential running duel against the attackers, which are usually faster than your defenders. If you haven't already got the ball, now it's time to take advantage of the better position. As you're now in control of the running duel, which means in front of the opponent, you can overcome the pace advantage of the opponent with your body. This means you use the shielding function, the L2 or T button, to hustle your opponent away. I like to use that function very dynamically. When I see the opponent is getting closer, trying to overtake me, I press and briefly hold that button. After that, I let go to keep running. Then maybe another use of shielding is required. This is what I mean with dynamic. Here I lose the ball after the throw-in, and instead of keep chasing from behind with my midfielder, I switch to my center back. Thus, I get in a good position to win the running duel. Right when the opponent gets close, I keep control over the duel with frequent use of the shielding function. In the end, I prevail and have full control over the ball. Now, towards the end of this video, we come to two rather last resort techniques that you should also always keep in mind and consider. One is pulling out the goalkeeper early by pressing and holding triangle or Y. In this situation, I saw the runner of the attacker in the center and tried to go for an early player switch, but recognized that I'm already too late for this. The pass is about to be played and the attacker is already much faster than me. See how early I pressed the button to pull out the goalkeeper? At the end, this was the deciding factor to not concede here. Keep in mind, I also did that in situations at which it wasn't needed. This is one of the through pass situations from the beginning of the video. As it also looked a bit desperate, I pulled out the goalkeeper while I was moving my defender back and in the end won the ball. But pulling the goalkeeper out in those situations can be a vital help. At last, we have another last resort that I personally try to avoid, but can be extremely helpful. When you notice that you are about to lose control over the situation, which means that the attacker is about to pull away and you see no real option to stop him soon, you can stop him right at his tracks with a foul. For example, a powerful standing tackle without much of a chance of actually getting to the ball clean. Here I see Haaland, a fast and also physical strong player, already accelerated and slightly in front of my Van Dijk. There is a decent chance that he just rushes past by me and then it would be also too late to switch to my other center back. That's why I instantly commit heavily to a standing tackle without a clear chance for the ball. I commit a foul but prevent Haaland from breaking through on goal. So at the end, with these 6 tips, you have a lot of techniques and ideas at hand that can help you quite a lot in order to keep your opponent in check. Basically, they all work together. First, you try to go for an early player switch to get your defender already running. A clever running path helps. Maybe you need another player switch to not trail behind. When you are then in a good position, you can use your body to get the ball in the end. If this all fails, you already started to pull out the goalkeeper or commit a foul. Don't get me wrong, pace is a huge factor in FIFA 21, but now you have techniques at your disposal to deal with it before it actually becomes a problem. Your player might be slower, but when you're quicker in your head, you can overcome that disadvantage. It requires understanding the game and what your opponent is about to do, and then a very concise action on your side. As always, it comes down to practice. Keep those principles in mind and try to apply them when you feel it's the right situation. Step by step, you will get more used to it and prevent the dangerous situations before it unfolds. And by this, I mean a fully accelerated attacker and you trailing from behind. We hope this video was helpful for you. If this was the case, please leave it a like and also share it with your friend. Subscribe to this channel and activate the bell when you're interested in more tutorial videos like this. You can also leave us feedback and ideas about what you would like us to cover in a video. At the end, don't forget to check out our website with all the information about our individual coaching offers with Pro, Top 200 and Elite players. Thanks for your attention, keep a clean sheet, I'm out.